One solution to the shortest path problem for weighted undirected graphs is called Dijkstra's algorithm. Let's say we're trying to find the shortest path from here to here. We begin by giving all vertices a distance value. A distance is the sum of edge weights on a path between our starting point and whatever vertex we're on. At the end of the algorithm, this distance will be the distance of the shortest path. The distance value we start with is infinity. This is a placeholder value that will update whenever we discover a node and have an actual distance to store. The node we're starting with will have a distance of 0. A common implementation of Dijkstra's uses a min priority queue, where the element with a minimum priority, or minimum distance in our case, can be removed efficiently. We store all of our nodes in the priority queue and use extract min to take out the minimum element, the only one with a distance of 0. From our starting node, we have several options. We will follow each edge and update the node on the other side with a distance value, which is just the weight of the edge. Now we're faced with a choice. Which node should we visit? We'll always pick the node with the smallest distance value, which means we run extract min on the queue. Because we always pick the node with the lowest distance, Dijkstra's is often called a greedy algorithm. The philosophy for this class of algorithms is pick whatever option looks best at the moment, hence the name greedy. We repeat the process, visiting all adjacent nodes that are still in the queue and updating their distance values if we can decrease it at all. We keep going, extracting the minimum from our queue and exploring adjacent elements until the node we're looking for has been extracted from the queue or everything else has a distance of infinity, which means the path we're looking for doesn't exist. The basic runtime of Dijkstra's is the number of vertices squared. Since in the worst case, we visit every node in the graph once or twice, and every time we visit, we need to search through the queue to find the minimum element. There are a lot of optimizations for Dijkstra's. If the priority queue is implemented really efficiently, the runtime looks more like this.